Good afternoon, and welcome to this week's 420 live sesh with your Midnight Greenery host, CannaCamie. Today we have the pleasure of interviewing Midnight Greenery's own, Tina Smith. Today we're going to discuss what happened over last week's Marijuana Control Board meeting to keep you up to date with what's blazing in our local canna community.
Hi!
So, we're still kind of new with what we have going on here on these weekly sessions, and we are still looking for a name. So we are hoping to look to you viewers to help us figure out what we should call these weekly sessions. We do have an awesome giveaway to the lucky contestant who does help us name the session. I don't want to give it all away, but it's going to be a new rig. So,
not giving it all away.
Don't want to give it all away, but it's going to be a rig. So if you want, you know, you can always give us feedback on this live video. You can message us on Midnight Greenery. Tell us what you like, what you don't like, what you see. If you have questions, please feel free to bring them up as we discuss during today's session. And speaking of giveaways, we do have a giveaway that we want to go ahead and do for today.
We were gifted, Green Jar brought us a sweet little thing, poster, and we have one that matches it that we're going to give away.
So at the end of today's video, we are going to call out a viewer who's with us, and they are going to take home the sister to this poster. So you'll have the same poster that we have in our backdrop for today.
And who knows, we might even get her to sign it.
Ooh. My handwriting's not that great. It won't be worth much. So, going off of what was talked about and discussed in last week's Marijuana Control Board meeting, a lot of good things were discussed, brought up, and we're ready to talk about it. And we hope that you're ready to listen, and we hope that you have some questions as well. So, we do know that some of our board members are going down to Washington.
Right.
Do we know what's going to be discussed down there?
They're going down for a regulators meeting. It's going to be Peter Mallark, who is our public safety representative on the MCB board, and then Erica McConnell. She's the new director of AMCO, which is basically the staff of the Marijuana Control Board and the Alcohol Control Board. So,
okay,
they're both going to go down there for a regulators meeting.
Perfect. Wonderful. They will definitely represent Alaska well for us. So I know that there was a meeting coming up for this summer, and they were supposed to be having it out in beautiful Denali. I heard that got switched to Fairbanks. Do we know why?
The scheduling, and the only time they could do it was summer, because that's the only time Denali Park is open.
Right.
But it's so expensive, and we all know we're in a deficit. So.
And it's in the middle of tourist season as well.
So they decided to go ahead and move that to Fairbanks.
And so what is that going to mean, moving it to Fairbanks? Is it going to delay the meeting by any time, or cost-wise?
It'll be a lot cheaper, because they can do it in a one of the lower-cost convention rooms.
So it sounds like the move is actually going to be more beneficial.
Right.
So that's actually wonderful.
More people will actually be able to attend it also, because to be able to go to Denali, and you know, you're going to have to get a room for most people, because it's a 300 mile drive for some.
Right.
It's really expensive in the summer.
So, I know there, just one of the few many things that was discussed at the Marijuana Control Board meeting was the talk of the edibles that are currently on the dispensaries and the current milligrams that are actually set in the regulations. What exactly did they talk about for that?
They were talking about how, well, basically it came with public comment. It was brought up that there was a doctor and a dispensary owner or a store owner who were bringing up 5 milligrams are not going to meet the needs for patients who medicate and would still like to be able to buy the medicine in a regulated market that is actually tested, and they know their percentages and they know what it's tested for. And right now, 5 milligrams a serving, there's no way.
And that was Kirby Coleman?
Yes, Kirby Coleman and Dr. Peterson.
Dr. Peterson.
Who had a really big hand in the marijuana, or in the say no on one.
Yeah, I think so.
The music's a little distracting.
Yeah, we should turn that down. I thought about that.
Thanks, Rebecca.
Thank you so much. This is the type of feedback we need. Thank you. It's very appreciated. So I know that in my experiences and going down and traveling in the lower 48 and being able to go into the different type of recreational stores down there, my first time actually, I walked into a medicinal store and I was turned away because I actually at that time did not possess a medical card. So I was, you know, very politely directed to the recreational store across the street. And I did. I asked them, I said, well, do you mind if I ask you the difference between the two? And there is a huge difference between the two. And now as a medical card holder myself, I know that difference. The difference between the medicinal store and the recreational store is the milligram and the THC percentage, because medicinal patients need to have that higher dosage to be able to control the pain and ailments in sleep or whatever it is that the cannabis is curing for them.
Right.
So I honestly do believe that I would like to see some medicinal stores as recreational.
Right. That's going to be something that's going to have to be changed in the legislature. Because right now, with the current regulations and the current legislature that's in place, it's only recreation.
Right.
And that's what we voted on.
And that's another, you know, say no to prohibition and decriminalize cannabis for sure.
Yep.
So what else was spoken about when, you know, what else did they say about the edibles in that point in time? Was there anything else more brought onto it other than, you know, we're hoping to see more than the 5 milligrams? Is there anything that we can hope for to see soon, or are we just kind of stuck in the air on that one?
Right now we're stuck in the air on that one until somebody can introduce some regulations to. And the way to get that done is public comment on it constantly. If you can get 5 to 10 comments per meeting about the same thing every meeting, they'll start paying attention and start wanting to make those regulations so they don't have to listen to it anymore.
Okay. And you can call in and listen to these marijuana control board meetings. You just want to make sure that your phone is muted. And they're always, you know, they're going to go, and some of these are, they're public comments. So they do go out to the public and they let you ask questions and interact and everything like that. So that is also nice that, you know, we are able to be heard, but I'm sure that there are also more ways for us to be heard as well.
Right. There's the public comment, and then you can also, you can write in. You can, if you want to do a public comment now, they do have where you have to actually register. You have to register to do your public comment now. And that's what, I think it's 2 weeks usually. You're required to do it by 2 weeks before the meeting so that you can get on the call list.
Okay.
Justin thinks we need to be smoking a little bit more.
I think so too.
I will take that challenge, sir.
I think that
Malenia
needs
has
to happen.
Some dabs working out here for you.
Excellent idea, Justin.
It might be a little easier if you just warm it up a little bit, swirl it in there so that the dab sticks. Beautiful.
So this was donated today by the lovely Rachel, who's behind the camera.
Our camera love.
That's Sage and Sour Diesel. It's a hybrid. It's a sativa dominant. It's BHO. Super clean. One of my favorites, actually. I pretty much made my husband bring it.
Got into a little bit more. I have the pineapple chunk. I'm not 100% sure if it's a hybrid, but I'm pretty sure it's a hybrid. It is also BHO, but it is absolutely fabulous.
Nice.
Thank you, lady.
Oh, there you go.
This is my lovely rig. She was recently named Gumby for her color. Mm. It was a very perfect fit, actually. A gal on Instagram said, you know, oh, you should name it Gumby the color. It's like, sold.
Yeah.
It was sold after that. It was kind of love at first sight out at the shack.
I need to go in there. I really need to go in there. Everybody keeps telling me awesome things about it, so.
It's because it's fabulous.
It's been a while. It's been a long time, so.
Yeah.
So how many viewers do we have?
9 at the moment.
Nice. Hello. Anybody got any questions so far? Kind of chill out. I was very nervous.
I was too. Still very nervous.
We're still working out the kinks of these live shows.
Excuse me. Woo!
Nice.
You'll have to excuse my smoker lungs.
Ed says you hit it like a champ, Camille.
I pretend like the best.
Got 14 viewers now.
So I do apologize in advance because I am sometimes good with names, but a lot of the times I'm not. So I do pre-apologize if I pronounce your name wrong. If you want to, you know, Google spell it out for me, the pronunciation, I will mentally take note of that for future sessions. So going back to the marijuana control board meeting, as we know, you know, everybody mutes their phone, but there are also people that are there in the live, in the present as it is happening.
Right.
So how was the room when Jana Weldson mentioned waiving the renewal fees for the newly licensed applicants?
Oh, that was a big one for the people who just, especially the people who just got licensed, because those renewals come up in July.
July or June?
I'm sorry, it's June.
June 30th.
Yeah, June 30th. And that's up to $5,000, $6,000 that they're going to have to pay again in 2 months. And they're not even going to be able to operate.
Now, are they doing that just from here on, or was that from the beginning of 2017? When did that start?
It's from here on, the people who just got licensed on.
Last week.
So, yeah. So, the people who got licensed at the MCB meeting on the 15th of March, I believe. I think it was the 15th of March. They still will have to, they will still have to pay the renewal.
Ouch.
Yeah, it's, this is not a cheap industry to be part of.
No.
It's very, you have to plan ahead. That's definitely it. It is doable. It is very, very doable. It's just something that you're going to have to really plan ahead for.
But I do know that there were some very long-awaited and deserved licenses that were granted at that last.
Yes.
So, and I do hope that they continue to just keep pulling out those applications and granting them, because it is well-deserved for everybody's hard work that we know you're putting in. So the only thing other than that with the new applicants, what about those who are licensed but they're not up and operating yet? Do they get this waiver as well? They don't.
No. Anyone who was licensed before that or got their license approved with delegation. So they're not actually approved to start producing or anything yet. They've got still a little ways to go before they can do that. I know people who were approved last year in Fairbanks and they still are not able to have a plant in their facility yet, because there's still a whole bunch more that has to be done.
The hoops are just on fire and never ending.
It really is. And that's one of the reasons, too, that I've heard one of the, well, we can go into it later if you want to finish the going into the MCB meeting, because this kind of goes outside of the MCB meeting.
Okay, yeah, we can always come back around to that. Yeah, no problem. So, a little bit on, let's touch on enforcement. So, I heard that there is a new regulations officer in Fairbanks.
Yes,
what does this mean
is.
For that area? Is this going to be a good thing or is it going to be kind of a bad thing? What is it?
I actually think it's going to be a good thing because we've got licenses that are waiting to get their walkthroughs and get their approvals. And,
inspections? Okay.
And, yeah, their inspections. And if you don't have the officers to do it, that gets put on the back burner. They're responsible for not only the marijuana industry, but also the alcohol industry.
Right.
So, you know, the more enforcement we can get, I mean, yes, I know that means that there's more people who can come in and hassle you.
Yes.
But that, yes, that is one of the things that we have to worry about. But be prepared for it.
But it's not like it hasn't already been happening much anyway.
Right.
But it just means that it'll happen a little more, hopefully not as aggressive.
Right. And hopefully they have their T's crossed and their I's dotted this time, if they ever do it again.
Yes, yeah. Agreed.
We're talking about the mass raids that they had for the CBDs. Mm-hmm. That was a couple months back.
Yes, that was very unfortunate. Just uncalled for and unfortunate.
Yep.
Just a very large loss. So, back to the regulators. How many do we have?
We have 6.
Inspectors, sorry. The regulators, inspectors.
Oh, yeah.
I guess I could call them.
Inspectors or
enforcers.
Enforcement. Yeah, we have 6.
Okay. Do we know if there's any plans for more?
I don't know. I mean, I know that they're always looking, but I'm not sure what the actual
qualification type thing is.
I know that this enforcement officer is a prior police officer and small arms instructor.
Oh, cool. Okay.
So he's got some police background, which, I mean, he's in enforcement, so
right.
It'd probably be a good idea that he does.
Yeah, so that's probably some of them. Okay. So we know that we're able to transport via, you know, car while we're, you know, coming over, you know, driving between here, friend's house, things like that. What about if, say, I wanted to go visit other places in Alaska, like Ketchikan, or if I wanted to go to Juneau, or a place that doesn't necessarily have a dispensary, like, I don't know why, but Hooper Bay, you know? What about traveling with air cargo, or traveling with marijuana?
No.
No?
Technically, no.
So then there would be no possible way for a cultivator to send
not
and
currently.
Work?
No, not currently. And that's one of the things that was brought up, is that they need to put some regulation language in for being able to send product to Anchorage to get tested if you're in Ketchikan.
Yeah, we only have one testing place.
We have
in
two.
Two now?
Mm-hmm. Well, one's in Anchorage, and I believe maybe they're both in Anchorage. I'm not sure.
And I do apologize for not having that information.
I apologize for not having that information. That brain fart.
So it sounds like we definitely need to get some more testing places out.
We need to get some regulations so we can have a traveling testing.
So then
how
does that work for the dispensaries and other locations if they don't have it tested because it's required to be tested?
They can't. It has to be tested. So I do believe...
I wonder if they can they do like a mobile testing and they fly with their testing kit out there.
That's
and test
one of the
it?
Things that we were talking about. That I'm sorry, not we, but they were talking about, and some of the comments had been about mobile testing and getting regulations so that we can have mobile testing, so that one of the testing facilities that's licensed can have a mobile lab that can go to Ketchikan, because we only have like one or two cultivators in very remote places, and so they don't need a whole, because we have to deal with the TSA requirements and then the air cargo requirements. So
okay.
Jason says, there needs to be more support in tax-free medical marijuana. It feels like the state has abandoned the sick and ill. I concur on that.
Yeah.
Completely.
I 100% agree with that. I also know that it's something that needs to be pushed in regulations. We need to get people active in making legislation change that. Because until then, until we do something about it, we're just kind of...
And the way to do that is to work together and to unite and to everybody come at them from all angles and to let them know that, hey, we're going to be heard and we want change.
It's the whole reason why I got part of MG was because I found the medical need for it and I wanted other people to know.
Yeah.
So
I cannot imagine
being able to medicate in a regulated recreational market. There is no way I could not afford it.
No,
and I don't care how much money someone makes. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, I wouldn't. No, I couldn't afford it either. You know, thankfully with my card, I'm able to grow, you know, at home and grow my own medicine, which, you know, that on it as it own. And that on its own, as we know, can also be expensive.
Right.
But
and I haven't been able to grow yet, and due to family things, but I've had friends who've been so gracious and have been amazingly huge helps.
Yes.
So that's how I've been able to.
Right.
You know, and then there's, you know, sometimes we just, you make your choices.
Yeah.
You know, and sometimes you just gotta make your choices.
And yes, no matter what happens. And, you know, and we know that some of you guys know that all too well, putting all your money out in there and, you know, unfortunately being one of those that aren't up and operating and having to pay your renewal fee coming up in 2 months. So, I mean...
Until they make some regulations for the medical user, we're always going to have a need for a black market. And that's just me saying that straight out. We have a need because there's no way we can medicate in the regulated market.
Yes. Did you?
Jason says, thanks for talking about it. That's my family's exact struggle. It's a form of medication for my wife. And the rec market, while great it is, unaffordable. So we are starting to grow our own.
Right.
Yeah.
Excellent. I mean, that's the best way to do it.
I applaud you being able to grow your own. That's,
and it's also just like it's a really awesome, self-gratifying feeling that it's just kind of like a big big pharma that's just like, I can do this myself. I can take care of myself. I grew my own medicine. Brush my shoulder off. I don't need you.
Oh, yeah. Hi.
Crystal says, home growing can be expensive and cumbersome. Are there measures in place to help those with cards to cover those costs so that they can grow medicine affordably?
No, there are not any currently.
That would be awesome, though.
So that's something that we all need to get behind. And, you know, just put your voices out there to not the MCB, because they can't do anything about recreational.
Right. Yeah.
They are, or not recreational, they can't do anything about medical. They are bound just to doing recreational.
Mm-hmm.
We have to get completely new legislation out there that is addressing the need for the medical user.
And I understand that things are federal, and it's illegal on a federal level, which is another thing that we all are going to have to tackle. But not being able to use my ATM debit card in the dispensary was the biggest slap in my face twice.
Yep.
Having to go next door to the bar to pull out money, and I don't drink. That was another slap in my face. And then walking out into the light of the dark bar, I was like, oh, hallelujah. But
right, I had it twice,
man,
too.
I was not happy. Two different stores, two different towns. And it's not their fault.
It's not their fault at all. No, what I was told.
It's not their fault. It is the bank's fault. That is the man's fault.
What I was told was the banks were flagging companies that rent those machines. So anything that was coming from those machines, certain banks were stopping the transactions on.
Yeah, my bank is one of those.
Mm-hmm.
And my
Mine
bank
too.
Is also shutting down personal accounts of those who applied for licenses.
Yeah. So you guys be careful on your banking, because that's just, have
research, I guess. I don't even know how you would research that, but I'm pretty sure there's a way you can see who is for and who is against. There has to be a way.
The last I did any visits with any of the bank, and they all said no.
All of them in town?
All of them in town.
And it makes sense. I mean, you know, they're federally funded, so why wouldn't they? But, well,
we've gotten a few, a couple tags and emails and things saying that there were banking opportunities,
mm-hmm.
but they're usually out of state and there's no here. So it's like, okay, so how do we funnel our cash?
Yep.
You know, for stores the cultivators, how do they funnel their cash? Where do they put it? And when I say funnel, it sounds awful, but that's what they've, you know.
And I had those type of questions too, you know, when it was first coming out, you know, I might have been, I don't know, what do you want to call it, ignorant or whatever, but I was like, how are they going to give you a W-2? How are you going to do your taxes? How are you going to get direct deposit? How is this going to work? But it's obviously working, because it's working in Denver and Colorado, and it's working in Washington. So, I mean, it's obviously working, but we just kind of need to step it up. And I don't know why Alaska is dragging their feet so hard, but it didn't take them this long.
They were booming. Their argument for it was they wanted to avoid the mistakes that Colorado and Washington did make, because they did have some hiccups, and some of them were major hiccups that cost some people their actual businesses.
Well, yeah, and I mean,
so,
that happens too, but you can also learn from other people's mistakes while still not just trying to be stuck in that little bubble.
Right.
You know, it's like, it's almost like they're taking that and using it to their advantage, because maybe they really just don't want this at all.
That was a thought of mine once or twice when things got just dragged and dragged and dragged. And I'm like, okay, are they trying to drag this out so that they can say that there's no way that there's a positive industry in 2017? But I think I think that ship sailed with showing that, yes, we are able to do it, and we have started to put some good money into taxes, and, you know, so I don't hear anything saying let's repeal this in huge, you know, loud voices.
Right. Oh man, those are two huge ones. I'm gonna take the inhaler after that one if I did that. Woo!
And speaking of inhaler, I forgot to bring it in.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, and I don't see the inhaler, so I'm not doing that. No, ma'am. Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm. Do you need it?
Not today, no.
Do you need the inhaler?
I can't hear you, honey.
Do you
no,
need
we don't
the
need
the inhaler.
Okay.
No,
I think
I'm good.
She'd be over here, like, give me the eye if she was needing the inhaler.
Yeah, if I'm like, yeah.
I'll be sure to grab it if you collapse.
trying to navigate asthma and, you know, my smoking. It's one of those things. It's a learning process. So it's been interesting. I have kind of limited to, I get to smoke during these. And I don't get to smoke flower. I miss it. I'm a concentrate girl now.
Does it help you concentrate?
It does help me concentrate. It seriously does help me concentrate.
I love that girl with all her puns.
Yes. So, do we have any viewers?
We've got 8 viewers.
Hello.
Ask questions, guys, if there's anything you're interested in knowing. Miss Tina's got the knowledge.
Doesn't even have to be about the board meeting or. What are you guys smoking on? That's a good one.
Or not, I don't know.
Maybe I do need the inhaler. Mm-hmm. No, I'm just kidding. I'm sorry, I'm just kidding.
One of the tricks I learned was inhale slowly.
Oh, Troy just commented. He said to Crystal, she had commented about how medicine can be grown affordably. Troy says, no, but Canadian insurance companies are starting to pick up the tab on medical marijuana for their patients, so it's not impossible. It's just that's not awesome. In the U.S. yet. So that's awesome. That's excellent.
Go Canada.
Information.
So send us, if you can find links on things like that,
yeah,
send it
great.
To the MG page. That would be phenomenal.
We're going to get an email set up once we figure out, you know, the name, which brings us back to that contest and that rig that I didn't tell you about.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's what our email will be for these weekly lives, for our giveaways, for questions, comments, concerns. Tell us what you like, if you think we should rearrange the table, if you think we should move this over there, or, you know, anything. What you got?
Do you like our girl? I think she's cute.
I think she's cute.
I think she's super cute.
That's the poster we're giving away as well.
I kind of wish I looked like her.
Don't we all?
Yes, I think we do. Except for the ones that do look like her. Okay, so I think we've gone a little off topic for a second here.
Oh, thanks, Troy. He added the link onto the...
Ooh, thank you.
Ooh, thank you.
That's perfect.
I'm excited to read that. So, okay, so we kind of wormhole, rabbit hole. I do like rabbit holes, though. They're hard to get out of, though. But you were talking about something about deliveries or...
We were talking about not being able to put your cannabis on a plane to go get tested.
I think it was before that. It was right before we had the question or comment about the medical marijuana. You were talking about, like, delivery services.
Oh, we didn't talk about delivery services yet.
But you had, I think you had said something, and I think that's what it made me think of delivery services.
Mm.
So wasn't there something about delivery services?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Kirby on one of, because he called in for public comment, and one of his comments was about the delivery services, like ACDC. Yeah, and they are doing a lot of advertising on radio now, and the problem with that is it's not technically legal.
No.
They don't have a license to sell.
Yeah.
And,
There
are no regulations that cover delivery right now, and if you are not covered under regulations for marijuana distribution, you're looking at actually having charges brought up against you.
I think the only type of delivery that would be available in any sense of form is the one from a friend to friend.
Yes.
You know, dropping off for a friend, you know, a donation, like, oh, here, you know, I know you need something. Or if you were somebody's caregiver.
Yes.
With as their a medical card, you know.
And that's actually covered under regulation.
Right, exactly. So, I mean, I think those are the only ways that you are legally able to deliver.
Right.
If you were, you know, obviously black market, everything about black market is illegal, but usually in the black market, you don't advertise.
Right. Yeah, usually. You'd think.
But that just, that whole situation just reminds me of a name that I'm not sure if I just want to drop right now or not. But I'm sure everybody's thinking it.
Oh, I just dropped the one. So, and it was one that he actually mentioned. He mentioned it in his comment. And I was like, congratulations, Kirby, for actually having the guts to say something about something you feel very strongly about.
But I'm pretty sure that, you know, they are.
Oh, yeah.
Wasn't it on the radio?
Oh, yeah, and there's actually,
faced
charges.
Yeah, so. I was going to say, isn't there something involving them already with the police, or maybe not yet, but it's like 40
or... Oh, yeah, there's been issues with it, yeah, and it's been all, it was last year or a year and a half ago, all those raids that were going on, and it's unfortunate because there's so many people who... I mean, I understand. I get it. I get that sometimes you just got to do what you got to do to survive.
Yes, but you don't advertise.
You don't advertise that. And they're making a good... I mean, I don't know this for a fact, but I'm pretty sure they're making some money. And all these people who are busting their butts to get that legal... license.
That's
and
a slap in the face.
It's a slap in the face. And the hundreds of thousands of dollars that they've invested. You know, so
I'm not saying that a delivery service is bad.
No, it needs to be in there.
It needs to be in there, absolutely, because that is so needed. There are so many medical patients that not only is the cost of the dispensary, but you know, whatever. But the delivery service, a lot of the patients can't get to the dispensary either.
Yes,
so they need to have that delivery service,
or they need to have something that is. Just a delivery service. It doesn't have to be attached to the store or...
Yeah,
just
a cultivator delivery service.
Some type of regulations that allow for somebody who has a marijuana handler's permit card that they just do deliveries. Just like you can get a specialized, especially down in the States, you call one number, you tell them you want Chinese food, and they find... You know, the place for you. You tell them what you want.
Now, the driver that is driving between the cultivation and the dispensary, do they have to take any type of extra class or course, or do they have to carry any type of extra card to be able to drive?
Well, they have... I mean, well, there's no regulation set up for it right now, but I can imagine that they would have to have their marijuana handler permit.
Obviously.
And then they would have to have whatever regulations your local area requires for people who do delivery, whether there's extra insurance that's on your car, or if you have to have a chauffeur's license. I don't know. That would be in the regulations.
Okay.
Or whatever your local government decides.
Because, yes,
decides.
Then they would be able to, well, I say that because then maybe they could regulate it as the delivery service the same way they regulate the driver between the cultivation shop, you know, warehouse, whatever, and the dispensary. Somebody has to drive it.
I mean, I think that in a perfect world, if somebody could introduce some regulations it's had, that a delivery company was able to pick up from the dispensary, put it in the locked box, and the person that it's getting delivered to has the combination that they got from the dispensary, and they're the only ones that can open it. You know, have it set up to where that type of technology, it's possible. So then you don't even have to worry about it being diverted from... You know, as long as it's already a customer that's in the system, all of their credentials have been, you know, researched and made sure that it's who it is that it's being delivered to, that they're over 21, then there is a way to do it. It's just going to take some time.
Mm-hmm.
I can go on
does.
Forever when it comes to the regulations and the possibilities.
Well, that happens. So, social media, we are... currently on. We are live on social media. Social media advertising, social media sells, social media is the new thing. It's the new life. It is, everybody is always on social media,
right.
On their phones, their tablets, their computers. It's just, it is what it is.
Yeah,
so how does that help the or hurt the...
Well, every dispensary and cultivation, they're all starting to get their Instagrams going and their Facebooks going, and they're advertising like 20% off pre-rolls, that kind of thing. Well, the enforcement officers had asked the MCB what their thoughts are. Do they need to have the warning signs that are required on all packaging to be on those advertising, which is also required in any other type of advertising? And that was the general consensus, is that yes, anytime you advertise anything with your store, you need to have your warnings on there, like, you know, make sure you're over 21, do not consume when pregnant, can impair your driving, that kind of stuff. The normal stuff that you usually see also on alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not all of them, I don't agree with all of them, but until we fix it, that's what it is.
Right. Understandable.
So yeah, if you're going to advertise and like you might want to advertise with local companies, just make sure that your advertisements have those warnings on there.
Okay, yes. Make sure to cover yourself so that you do not get in trouble and fined, and hopefully not worse.
Right.
So, what have we changed the regulation on giving out, on dispensaries being able to give out samples?
Nope. Zero samples can go out.
That they haven't budged at all.
They haven't budged at all. And that was a question also that was brought up, because someone wanted to do a donation to a local charity for, I think it was vets. And don't quote me on that, because I think that's what it was, but I'm not sure 100%. And it was, nope, absolutely not. They cannot donate any kind of, and you cannot have samples, period. They're going to make some actual regulations right now where... well, they're working on it to where you can actually do quality control, because as it is right now,
mm-hmm.
A bakery cannot test and taste the things that they've actually created.
Hmm.
So, and a cultivator cannot test his flower.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
That's just...
So it doesn't make for really great quality control.
No.
Well,
cause you
they can... But you have to be able to put it out to the stores first and then be able to purchase it back from the store.
Oof.
Yeah.
Vicious cycle.
Yep.
Oof. Ugly cycle. You gotta test it and taste it along.
Yep.
Oh no. You have. Oh.
Can you imagine if something was just a little bit off and you didn't know it and you sent out a complete batch that was just off and there goes your name on that batch? Because you know that the...
I can feel it from every single standpoint, from the cultivator all the way down to the consumer.
Mm-hmm.
I can completely understand and feel all of the feelings. And it's not their fault.
No.
And it's not their fault.
It's in right now. They're working on getting that changed so that it can be tested. Yeah.
Right.
Crystal has a question. She says, hold on, a cultivator cannot test their own product?
No. Not unless they buy it from the retailer.
After it's already dispersed.
Brianne says, do you know how that compares to the regulations in other places where marijuana is legal?
I don't off the top of my head. I can look into that, though, and look on the Midnight Greenery page, because if I find it, I will post it so that you can read up on it.
Okay. Sounds good. That's a good question.
Yeah, it was. Thank you.
And that is something that we're going to have to kind of brush up on, too, is all of the regulations in the different states, too, so that we can do these kind of comparisons.
Right.
Might help out a little bit, too, see what they have.
Since we're still really new in this, there's going to be a lot of things that we're going to notice as we go, and we're probably going to point them out. So we would really love for you to help us with that and point out some things that we could do a little bit differently if we need to. So,
and we do apologize if we don't have all the information for your questions either at the immediate moment. But once we do have them, like she said, we'll post them up on the Midnight Greenery Facebook page, and then we'll get information posted out on the Instagram page.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll start doing the Instagram live videos as well as Facebook, and hopefully onto YouTube as well. Kind of get up a little bit of a bigger platform out there as well. So that'll be nice. Stay tuned for that.
Yeah.
So I do know that we haven't seen any keef in the dispensaries. Do we have any plans or hopes to see that happening soon?
Well, that's kind of one of those up in the air things, because there's no spot in it or spot for it in the metric system, which is the seed to sale tracking system that the state runs on. So there's no way to test it. There's no way to do any of that for it. So until that has regulations in place, you're not going to see it in dispensaries for a while. Well, yeah, you're not. I mean,
you'll just have to collect your own from what you get at the dispensaries. Yeah.
Because they're still asking the question of whether they can sell it that way and how it's found. Because you know that there's the hand trim and then there's the machines. And you get to gather a lot more keef that way. Well, they want to know, are you separating it? And is that a production thing? Because that's a concentrate. So it's... That was one of those really kind of... It just kept going, and it was a carousel of just back over and over and over again on the same issues. So it needs to be tested. We need to have a spot for it to be tested. We need to figure out whether it's something cultivation can do or if it has to be production.
Mm. Where are loopholes?
Yeah. Just depends on which board member you ask, actually.
You know, I kind of say I don't love when that happens. I don't.
And we've got, each board member has their own personality, and somebody who's been there a lot can, yeah.
Troy says he bought a bowl of keef from a storefront in Anchorage last week after the NCB meeting.
Really?
Nice.
Which one, Troy?
I haven't been to all of them, and there's one by my work that I can't go to because for obvious reasons, but yeah, which one?
It's probably that one.
Probably that one. So, I mean, we'll see what happens with that. But that was the discussion that was during the MCB meeting. So, I never know what they're thinking. So,
Troy says, but I don't know that it didn't get routed through a processing facility.
So it's just kind of basically like the CBD or something that we got. I don't know. But there's no regulation on it. Unless it's changed extremely recently.
Well,
Dankerage.
See, they were closed when I tried to go up in there.
I don't know. I mean, I'm not an enforcement officer and I'm not a lawyer, so I don't know.
Yeah, true.
All I know is what I witnessed and what I heard at the MCB meeting, so.
True.
Will says cultivation facilities should be allowed to produce dry sift and water hash with limited regulation, both safe processes.
Right, and it's just a natural process. It's not something that, it's not having to go through any chemical process or anything like that.
Oh, no, it's not hard. It's just physical labor.
Right.
Well, I guess depending on which way you do it.
I don't understand. And, well, that was another question, too, that before the last MCB meeting was pre-rule something that had to go through production.
Yeah.
What? No, why would it have to go through production? It's just rolling it up, packaging it.
Mm-hmm. Well, and then I hear the debate on, you know, pre-rolls having trim versus bud, and and then I'm just like, my eyes just get kind of big and glossed over, and I'm just like, what?
There's just so much. It's, everything's changing so very, 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 very quickly. It's fun, though.
Don't you judge me.
Oh, no. Oh, so one of the really interesting things, the comments from, well, actually one of the really interesting licenses that went through, there was a lot of more opposition than they've ever had before. And it was because of the Talkeetna High Expedition. Talkeetna, that shop, finally got its license.
Crystal says, "Kay, I'm nosy, ladies. What's in the paper bag?" That's an excellent question.
Very good question.
I love that.
I was kind of wondering if anybody was going to say anything about that. Would you like to?
You do it, please.
Give me just a second.
Let me see what it says. Nice. I love the logo. I absolutely love it.
All right, so these were a Midnight Greenery donation by Smash the Pastryarchy. They are donuts, espresso flavored donuts, and then Earl Grey muffins. And then they are, she says it's 30 milligrams per bag. So.
What are you giggling about over there?
Don't ask me.
Yes, Crystal, it's lip sense on Camille.
Hey.
She also says that's a devious look, Miss Tina. Miss Tina always looks devious.
What? But it's a good look. I'm an angel. What are you talking about?
Now she's just lying.
Right?
So, yeah, you'll have to make sure that you hit up our girl Toba Knight for these awesome custom cakes, pastries, and more. And I tell you, I haven't had the donut, so I'm super, super stoked about that. But I've had cakes, I've had muffins, I have had cupcakes, I have just completely gorged myself until I was just absolutely sick of never. Actually, I'd lie, I ate it all, but it's, you have to definitely take a look and give her a shot because these are absolutely fabulous. I've already had the muffins, but not the donuts.
I'm gonna get a close-up.
She makes beautiful cakes. She makes absolutely beautiful cakes.
She makes custom cakes. She has got mad talent.
Can I see the bag?
Yeah, here, you want one too? Take one too. So.
Oh yeah, I want to show them though. So that's Miss Toba. It's amazing. She's it's just divine food. Mm-hmm. I cannot tell you enough.
So the stuff that she has for sale is the non-infused things she's got. She's not doing, she doesn't have a license yet, so she does sell the non-infused pastries and goodies, and she's got, her cakes taste so good.
They do, and
they're beautiful.
They're beautiful. They're absolutely fabulous. She was just a doll and loves us and was able to, you know, provide us with some medicated ones.
Yes.
But.
And she loves us.
I'm going to tell you right now, I can guarantee it tastes the exact same and mwah, oh, so good. That's like, it's a good thing that bag is over there.
Crystal says, were these the espresso glazed donuts? Her wake and bakes? Yes. And they were divine.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. They were fabulous. Oh, yeah. I'm going to devour those. My laptop went black. So, I know that there was the packaging, exit packaging.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, the exit packaging from the dispensaries.
Yeah, there was the question from, I think it was enforcement. They were talking about the exit packaging. And was it, did the exit packaging have to be child resistant and opaque or just opaque? As long as the packaging inside that contained the cannabis, as long as that was child resistant. So that got clarified. And yeah, as long as the packaging is child resistant, the exit packaging does not have to be child resistant. Now, if it's somebody that the cultivation facility does its own packaging, or not the cultivation, but the retail facility does its own packaging, gets it in bulk, then they're going to have to supply exit packaging that is child resistant. So it all depends on what the
And those are usually a solid black, solid white, can't see through them, child-proof mechanism for opening and closing, smell-proof, so.
Right. I've seen some really interesting ones, too, and some ideas for some really interesting ones with, like, your logos on them and having, like, some kind of, if you bring it back, you get, you know, like, 5% off or something like that. If you bring your bag back, because they're expensive. Those bags are expensive.
Yeah,
especially if they're the large ones.
I don't remember what they charge for them, like $3 maybe? I don't know. I didn't even look at my receipt to tell you the truth, because then, you know, I was going to look at the tags, and I was just like, no.
And, you know, it's one of those things that it's either going to come back onto the customer, and the customer's going to have to pay for those bags, or it's going to be something that they're going to want to do, like a you know, somebody who comes in often, keep bringing your bag back.
Yeah, that's exactly what Crystal just said, is they like you to reuse them.
Yeah, and that's what they said down in Colorado, too. And I was like, I'm from Alaska. I might be back in, like, I don't know how many years.
Right.
I kept, probably lose it by then.
I always keep all my packaging anyway, just because it's fun. And I'm just keeping track of the journey as we do it. And I've seen some really interesting bags, and I've seen some really interesting packaging and branding. And you could do some really cool stuff with branding and some of these bags that you're required to have.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Melanie says in Colorado they charge you for the bag and encourage you to bring it in every time you go there.
Yep.
And they, on that note, they do have awesome designs on some of the bags. I kept a couple. And then there was a couple shops in Colorado where it was just paper bags, too.
Yeah.
So just kind of depended on where you went.
Right.
Yeah, see, I don't know, man. I don't mind those white or black, the bags or whatever, but if you kind of have me a paper bag, I'm going to be like, I was going to put it in my pocket. Because I don't want to be walking out there. Because to me, I associate it. Staple my pocket shut. I associate those with liquor, and I don't drink. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah. I mean, it's just, I don't mind carrying around that black bag.
Whole reason is because they're afraid it's going to offend somebody who sees it, or someone's going to be, shocked, we see marijuana.
I just walked out of a pot shop.
Exactly. Come on now. There's signs everywhere that says no one under 21 can go in. It's kind of,
it was literally right next to the bar. Which one are you more offended? I'm coming out sober, or I'm coming out sloshed?
Like, I mean, and seriously, some of the stores, you really have to be right on.
Sorry, I apologize, I don't drink.
Some of them you have to be right on the doors in order to see that they're actually a pot shop, because they've done them very classy and beautifully, but it's still a pot shop that they're walking out of, and it's not like, oh my goodness, they're seeing green flower or, you know, a bottle of something. It's teach your children. Teach your children.
I know a lot of people that do.
I don't understand why it's something that is so.
I don't know why it's offensive.
Yes. Yeah.
That's. If it's anybody can explain it to me, please somebody enlighten me, because I would love to know.
I mean, I understand the people who don't know, and they haven't been educated, because they still have to deal with all that 70 plus years of propaganda that was shoved down their throat. So we have to fight that stigma.
Yeah.
And doing it one step at a time, and doing and keep reinforcing it over and over and over again without the negative, and we've got so much more that we can actually educate.
Yeah, but we all have our own reasons on why we think that it's, you know, not already federally legalized, because it's just obvious. I mean,
it doesn't have anything to do with.
But there's just no reason on why not. I mean, if obviously, you know, you can look around and seeing on how many different places, even in around the world, are, you know, legalizing it recreationally, and whether or not they recognize it medicinally, they will.
There are a couple of bills up right now in front of the U.S. Isn't it Senate Bill? I can't remember which one it is right now off the top of my head. Do you know what it? Do you have it?
No, I do not.
But there's bills up right now that are going to try and deschedule it completely.
Yes, I do remember we talked about that.
Crystal asks, the regs on edibles, do you think they'll be changed ever?
Working on it. Keep commenting on it. The more you comment on it, the more inclined they are to actually change it. If you don't comment on it, they don't think that anybody cares.
Yeah, the thing that it's just okay how it is. I mean, I'm not saying that 5 milligrams is wrong, but I mean, that's good for a beginner and things like that. But for somebody that's a medical patient and has a high tolerance like I do, I can sit there and eat in the hundreds or even larger in towards the thousands and still be 100% functional and not feel like it even did a dent into anything. So, I mean, for some reason, I have this crazy tolerance that I just. And
I understand.
It's not my fault.
I understand selling some at 5 milligrams for those brand new users.
I'm just
but
saying variety.
Don't make it cap at 5.
That's
ridiculous.
Give me a 5. Give me a 10. Give me a 20. Give me a 50. Give me a 100. Give me a 500. Give me a 500.
You can't even get a package over 50 milligrams.
Oh.
It's ridiculous.
It's not going to do anything. It's a waste of my money.
Troy says they have to change the regs or I'm never going to lose weight. And Crystal says, someone made a joke, you'd get diabetes before feeling anything from dispensary edibles.
Yes.
But that's why, I mean, there's so much more than just treats.
Right, and they're making some savories.
There's, well, I mean, there's just food. Like, I mean, I'm talking dinners, meals, like infused meals.
I love the thought of being able to buy some olive oil just to be able to saute my vegetables with.
I made some. I got a magical butter machine.
Ooh, oh, would you do that?
Oh,
I love it.
You provide? I use the machine.
Nice.
Hi.
Melody says edibles in Colorado start at 5 milligrams, but candy bars are 100 milligrams. On that note, when we went to Colorado, we drank a drink that was 100 milligrams, ate a candy bar, and I don't know, 50 milligrams of something else. And that was like perfect for the plane ride.
Yeah, I drank a tea that was 100 milligrams and ate a candy. And I didn't have to take Xanax. I was like, yes, hallelujah. But it got spendy.
Yeah, see, last time we rolled through a dispensary, my husband and I were in Colorado, going through Colorado on our way to Vegas, and we just ended up getting some pre-rolls and some concentrate. So we didn't even mess with the edibles. I was like, nah.
No. I like to go because it's one of those things that's market research.
True.
I like to see what the different dispensaries are doing, where their technology is, how they've... Because I remember when it first... Can you remember the brownies of the olden days that had actual plant in it? Yeah, I've been around that long.
So, also, on 420, because it is, you know, coming up very quickly, you know, we got 10 days, 11 days, it's the 9th.
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing on 420? Because I'll be at my day job, but you...
We'll be doing a live at Green Degree. Because they're doing their grand opening on 420. So we'll be doing a live broadcast from their grand opening. They're going to have some live music and some hot dogs. And
I'm jealous because I want to be there.
Yeah, it's a long time in coming. They worked really, really hard to make sure that the Valley was able to have any kind of marijuana establishments at all.
Right.
And now they get to actually... open up, and that's really exciting.
And then I think we are ending the night down at Potluck?
Possibly? Yes. It's a possibility, so look for that.
Hopefully.
More info on the MG page.
Yeah, more info on the MG page.
Yes.
So we've been going for an hour now, so...
Yeah, I figured it's time to maybe do a few more dabs, or a dab at least, and then see if we have a somebody for the winner for the spare poster. I'm getting confirmation that we do, so.
Looks like Troy Foley was the winner.
All right, Troy.
Nice, Troy.
You have a beautiful, nice little poster.
PM us with your info so we can make sure and...
Or just a quick, are you in Anchorage or in the Valley? Or where? A good location that'll help real quick.
That and how old are you?
Yeah, 21 and over.
Yes.
Yeah, I guess we should put that in, like, the disclaimer of everything.
Are you 21 and or older there, Troy?
Well, I guess maybe for just rolling papers, wouldn't it be 19?
19, yeah. I don't know. We don't have...
Oh, he's 33. We're good.
I'm not a doctor. I just play one.
You're baby.
Yeah.
Okay, well then, no, absolutely. And then did we find out if he's in Anchorage or...
Yeah, are you in Anchorage or the Valley or outside of either of those places?
Because then that'll just determine on if...
3 miles from Green Degree.
Nice! So I'll be seeing you on 420, I'm sure.
Is that out? Where is that? Oh, it's in...
It's off, what, KGB, right? Yeah.
Oh, is that here in the Valley?
Yeah.
Okay. So then it'll stay here. Those were all the points that I had.
Sweet.
Anybody have any questions on the feed before we go, guys?
Any feedback for us?
Yeah, any suggestions?
You did good on this, or you need to change this, bad on this, move this, do more of this, less of that. unless it's less coughing, because I can't. I just can't help it. Asthma. I apologize. I can take like little baby dabs.
My husband says, "Nice hoodie, Camille."
Mm. Oh, thanks. I think it's yours.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Crystal says she loves this show.
It's cold in here.
Nice.
I've been in here like kind of shivering. You can't tell.
We've thought about possibly getting some. Well, it's not possibly. We're gonna get some t-shirts made soon. So, and we'd like to see if some of the local dispensaries or some of the local retail establishments, the local shops. Sorry, that was a good dab. Some of the local shops will carry them, and then maybe give some for giveaway. Now and then.
Before we go, Troy said he wanted to bring his kiddos for the hot dogs if they're grilling outside. Is that possible at Greenery?
I don't know. That's something that, because it's a marijuana establishment,
right,
for a grand opening. I'm not sure that it's a good idea to bring any children. I don't know. That's something that, it's not my store, but I would suggest not.
That's kind of what I would think, too. I'm thinking it's a 21 and over, regardless of...
Right.
I think it's just too
consider
new
otherwise.
Consider
it like
otherwise.
An alcohol event, basically.
Yeah.
A pot event.
It's an open
like
bar,
and
basically.
Just remember, too, it's their grand opening, and if anything does, they do get any kind of complaint, and enforcement comes down, it might look negative on them, and they've worked so hard to be open. I don't know. It might be open to the families. I would suggest calling Green Degree.
He's going to take the hot dogs to go.
Yeah, perfect.
There you go.
Good call, Troy.
I would do that anyway.
But I would suggest calling Green Degree and getting their actual, what their policy is on that.
Well, I think that's everything that I had. What about you?
Nope, I'm good.
All right. Well, if you enjoyed, catch us next week. We'll let you know what day. We'll get it on Facebook and Instagram, my Instagram, and maybe Lindsay will be back with us next week. It'll be on her Instagram. We'll let you know.
And this will be on YouTube by the end of the evening, so you can share it, and also you can share it when you're watching it, too, I believe, so...
Always. And then don't forget to maybe possibly let us know what we can call these weekly sessions and win that dab break that I didn't tell you about.
We also would like to have more guests on the show. And
yeah,
Camille
absolutely.
Would love to ask them some questions. And if you know anybody who'd like to be on the show, let us know. Have them contact us. That would be great. And send us some ideas. What kind of shows would you like to see? Who would you like to see on the shows?
And for now, you can message us on, you know, Midnight Greenery's Facebook page or their Instagram page, either or, and we'll get back to you.
Thanks for hanging out with us.
Until we get that email.
Oh. Peace out, y'all.
Bye.